Hello students, we are going to study social science of 7th standard. Before starting with the chapters, let us go through Indian history. Indian history basically can be divided into three: ancient period, medieval period and modern period. Ancient period you had learned in 6th standard. The primitive age, the rules of Indian rulers like Ashoka, Chandragupta Maurya, all these things you had learned in 6th standard. This year we are going to focus on medieval period, and in the 8th standard you are going to learn about the modern period. That is the arrival of Britishers in India and further. In medieval period, if we talk about, it is again divided into two parts. The early medieval period, that is from 6th century to 13th century. And the next one is late medieval period, that was from 13th century to 16th century. So we are going to start with medieval period. We are going to start with social science of 7th standard. The very first chapter, two big states. India was ruled by two big kings during that time. The first part of India, that was North India, was ruled by Harshvardhan, about whom we are going to study in detail in this chapter. The second was South India, which was ruled by Pulkeshi II. Let us start with the first part of the chapter, that is North India, which was ruled by Harshvardhan, Kannauj. Kannauj is in Uttar Pradesh. We are going to learn about Harshvardhan. Before that, let us start from the dynasty, Vardhan dynasty. Prabhakar Vardhan had three children: Rajyavardhan, Harshvardhan and Rajeshwar. Rajyavardhan was ruling over Thaneshwar, that is in the areas of Punjab, Haryana. Later on, Rajyavardhan was attacked by Shashank. Shashank was the king of Gaur in Bengal. This Gaur place is in Bengal. Shashank attacked Rajyavardhan and Rajyavardhan was killed. On the other hand, Rajeshri was the sister of Rajyavardhan and Harshvardhan. She was imprisoned by Devgupt. Who is Devgupt? He was the king of Malwa. Rajeshri was married to Grahavarma and he was ruling Kannauj. Kannauj is in Uttar Pradesh. So Devgupt imprisoned Rajeshri. Now Kannauj was without a king. Now meanwhile, what happened? As advised by all the ministers of his kingdom, Harshvardhan was given charge of Thaneshwar, because Thaneshwar was without a king. So Thaneshwar was now ruled by Harshvardhan. So after becoming king of Thaneshwar, the very first thing he did was to free his sister Rajeshri from the clutches of Devgupta. So what he did? He took help of Divakar Mitra. Who was Divakar Mitra? Divakar Mitra was a Buddhist hermit. He took help of Divakar Mitra and people who were living in the forest. He took help of these people and found Rajeshri. During that time, she escaped from the clutches of Devgupta and fled into the Vindhya forest. So Harshvardhan, with the help of Divakar Mitra and the people of forest, found Rajeshri and stopped her from becoming a Sati. Now what happened later on? Harshvardhan formed an alliance with Bhaskar Varman. Who was Bhaskar Varman? King of Kamrup. Where is Kamrup? Assam. He took help of Bhaskar Varman. These two together attacked Shashank. Who was Shashank? Shashank was the one who had killed Rajyavardhan. He was the king of Gaur and he had killed Rajyavardhan, about which we had earlier discussed. So these two together made an alliance and attacked on Shashank. Shashank was defeated and Harshvardhan conquered Malwa and Saurashtra also. Major portion of Malwa and Saurashtra were conquered by Harshvardhan. So like this you can see how brave and responsible King Harshvardhan was. Harshvardhan was very brave and he kept on progressing day by day. Harshvardhan was unsuccessful in defeating Pulkeshi II. Who is Pulkeshi II? Pulkeshi II was the ruler of Chalukya dynasty. Chalukya dynasty in South India. About him we are going to learn later on. Harshvardhan was unsuccessful in defeating Pulkeshi II. After 7 successive years, for a long time if you see, Harshvardhan became powerful and powerful day by day. And Thaneshwar emerged as a very big kingdom during that time. So here we understood about Rajyavardhan and the portion which is not related to his rule. Now we are going to learn about Harshvardhan's reign and administration. Reign means to rule and administration means to organize and manage things. तो यहाँ पर हम पढ़ने वाले कि हर्षवर्धन के रूल दरमियान किस तरह से पूरा कामकाज किंगडम का मैनेज होता था. दैट इज व्हाट वी आर गोइंग टू लर्न राइट नाउ. हर्षवर्धन यूज्ड टू पर्सनली ट्रैवल टू हिज किंगडम एंड सी हाउ द एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन वर्क वाज गोइंग ऑन. सो ही यूज्ड टू टेक पर्सनल इंटरेस्ट इन हिज किंगडम रिगार्डिंग द एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन ऑफ द वर्क. हिज डेली रूटीन वॉज डिवाइडेड इन टू टू पार्ट्स. The very first one is administrative purpose. He used to see how the things are going on in his kingdom. Whatever has to be taken care of was done by his personnel. The later part of the day was divided into two, that is public welfare and religious activities. Public welfare means the benefits, the facilities which the people want, that are all public welfare. So during that time, Harshvardhan, it was his duty that whatever people wanted from him, the benefits and facilities in their village, what they wanted was supervised by him and taken care of. लोगों को जो सुविधाएं चाहिए थी उनका सारा ध्यान में रख के एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन होता था. रिलीजियस एक्टिविटीज, हर्षवर्धन यूज टू अरेंज कॉन्ग्रेगेशन एंड प्रेयर. व्हाट इज कॉन्ग्रेगेशन? कॉन्ग्रेगेशन मींस गैदरिंग. जहां पर लोग इकट्ठा होते हैं उसे गैदरिंग कहते हैं. सो देयर वाज कॉन्ग्रेगेशन एट प्रयाग. प्रयाग इज इन उत्तर प्रदेश. एवरी 5 years. तो मेनी अ टाइम्स ही यूज्ड टू फॉरगेट हिज मील्स आल्सो, बिकॉज़ वी कैन सी हाउ ही वाज डेडिकेटेड टुवर्ड्स हिज वर्क, टेकिंग केयर ऑफ हिज सब्जेक्ट्स. सो मेनी अ टाइम्स ही यूज्ड टू फॉरगेट हिज मील्स आल्सो. सो प्रिंस बाय हर्षवर्धन. इम्प्रिंस मींस इम्प्रेशन. आफ्टर बिकमिंग द किंग ऑफ थानेश्वर एंड लेटर ऑन कन्नौज, हर्षवर्धन हैड मेड सम फैसिलिटीज फॉर द पीपल ऑफ हिज किंगडम. ही बिल्ट रेस्ट हाउसेस, Viharas, lakes, temples and mutts. Viharas and mutts, we call as mutas also. These were made as a religious institution for the people. And lakes, temples, these were made in the kingdom so that people do not have to go to other villages and get the basic necessity of life, that is water. So lakes and temples were also built for the subject of his kingdom. Further, he prohibited animal slaughter. Slaughter means killing. Killing of animal was not done during his rule in his kingdom. Religious congregation at prayer every 5 years was held during his time. During his reign, congregation, religious congregation, congregation word we have already learned. Congregation means gathering. So religious gathering used to happen every 5 years. Where? At Prayag, which is in Uttar Pradesh. So through this we can understand that he was very caring about his subjects. He was also religious. Okay, he used to donate all his ornaments which he was wearing during the congregation, and he used to empty his treasure also. So this shows that he was a big donor. He used to do charity also. Further, in his kingdom, a Sanskrit scholar was there who was adorned in his kingdom. He was Banbhat. Banbhat was a Sanskrit poet, and he wrote two books, that is Harsharit and Kadambari. Harshvardhan himself was a good writer, and he wrote 3 plays. Plays means drama, jinko natak bhi kehte hain Hindi. So he wrote 3 plays. They were Ratnavali, Kadambari, and Priyadarshika. Through this we can understand that he was very caring about his subjects. He used to take care of animals also. He was a big donor. He used to like charity, and he was a good writer also. And in his kingdom, he adorned scholars. Nalanda University. Nalanda University was one of the famous, world famous university during that time. Harshvardhan gave possible assistance. Assistance means help, whatever help the university wanted. He gave all possible help to Nalanda University. There was an acharya named Shilbhadra. Nalanda University was given access to use revenue of 100 villages for the maintenance and upkeep of the university. Revenue is a portion which goes to the king in the form of income. So that was of revenue of 100 villages was given to Nalanda University to keep it, to maintain it properly, because it was a world famous university and there were so many people coming from different countries. It had to be maintained accordingly. Acharya, there in Nalanda University there was a chemist named Acharya Nagarjuna. He proved that iron arsenic, we know it's a poison, but it has to be used very wisely before making it into a medicine. So iron arsenic and mercury ash, ash yani raat jo cheezon ko garam karte hain uske baad jo uska remain reh jata hai, that is ash. So mercury ash could be used as medicine. So these type of acharya, these type of professor were there in Nalanda University. We learn about Nalanda University. If you have to take admission in Nalanda University,